આજે ફાગણ સુદ બીત છે. પ્રેયર ઇઝ મોર ધેન અ વિશ, ઇટ ઇઝ ધ વોઇસ ઓફ ફેથ ડિરેક્ટેડ ટુ ગોડ. વિથ ધીસ લેટ અસ ઓલ ડિવોટ અવર સેલ્વસ ટુ ધ ઓલમાઇટી.
દેર લગેગી મગર સહી હોગા, હમે જો ચાહીએ વહી હોગા, ક્યોંકિ દિન બુરે હૈ મગર વો ઉપર વાલા નહીં. ઇસીલિયે રખો ભરોસા ઈશ્વર પર, તુમ કરો ઉન પર હી વિશ્વાસ. જબ ભી હોગે તુમ હતાશ, નહીં કરેંગે વો નિરાશ. આઈએ સુનતે હૈ એક તુ હી ભરોસા.
હો જાઓ કે સબ મિલકે રબ સે દુઆ માંગે, જીવન મે
empowerment has become a significant topic of discussion in development and economics. Economic empowerment allows women to control and benefit from resources, assets, and income. It also aids the ability to manage risks and improve women's well-being. Women empowerment allows women to boost their status through literacy, education, training, and creating awareness. Now I would like to invite some of the wordsmiths to throw some more light on women empowerment and their rights.
Imagine a gender equal world. A world free of discrimination, stereotypes, and bias. A world which is diverse, equitable, and inclusive. A world where difference is valued and celebrated. Together, we can all forge women's equality. Together, we can all break the bias. Individually, we are all responsible for our thoughts and actions all day, every day. We can break the bias in our campuses. We can break the bias in our workplaces. We can break the bias in schools, universities, colleges. Together, we can break the bias on International Women's Day and beyond. Deliberately or unconsciously, bias makes it difficult for women to move ahead. Knowing that bias exists isn't enough. Action is needed to level the playing field. Are you in? Will you actively call out discrimination and stereotyping each time you see it? Well then, let's start with a quick and easy riddle.
A huge trading company has started from a small shop and has evolved into a large company worth lakh rupees. A man has a job interview with the company. Few minutes before the meeting, he gets a call and he asks for permission from his father. The caller says, "Good luck, son." How is this possible if his father is sitting right next to him the whole time? Oh, just a bit close. It was his mother. Did anyone guess that? Mostly no one, right? We all are biased in a way. We don't even know. Of course, it's not that easy to break the bias, but a little sensitive push might work. Let's hear more about this from Arvi through a poetry. Let's test if we could actually control that monkey brain and believe on gender equality.
Did you grow up being told that you throw like a girl? You should be playing with dolls. You should be doing girly things instead, like playing with makeup. That women belong in the kitchen. That you are going to get hurt if you do that. You aren't tough enough. You aren't smart enough. That you just don't get it, or you are just not the right fit. But what if we are encouraged to succeed, motivated to win, supported and loved, and taught that fairness, confidence, courage, ambition, discipline, and strength are what women really made of? That whatever dreams you have can come true. You don't have to do anything but be yourselves, and you'll find your purpose and a career where you are respected. Doing what you love, you will learn that most women are fearless and we hold great power within us all. So we can teach what's right to others, as it's the only fair we feel safe wherever we are and find comfort knowing we will succeed in our growth and feel valued enough to take the lead or resilience to do anything. And lay the path of opportunities for those who walk with us, because we all deserve this equality. But you must speak up for injustice in whichever form it exists. There is a hope for better future if you all help to break this bias. Thank you.
A language seems very calm and peaceful, but yet speaks words as sharp as swords. It is a language in which people don't have two opinions. They all want the same thing, but still are scattered. Everyone in this language are the same. Tell, which language are we talking? Yep, guys, you're right. The language of of equality is the kindest language one speaks in these times. Let's invite Jill to throw some light upon this.
Yeah, we have all long forgotten this language that ages back in the times of Harappa. Today is a great day to rejuvenate this language, which speaks words as sharp as fire.
Once upon a time, there was a language that was only spoken by a few. The privileged were fluent, but the rest hoped to pursue. Ironically, it was called the language of equality, but the language never reached the true tongues and students it hoped to reach, because the people who had learned didn't plan to teach. So there was a rebellion. People threatening to create their own language, to make their own music, reclaim their tongues. I'm not sure you believed it, but it was women at the forefront who weren't willing to settle, cause it mattered, they knew. They challenged the hypocrisy with pens and books, with learnings and questions, with words unheard, cause they knew that the language of equality was what they deserved. But now it has been over centuries, people have come and gone. With every loss of individual, there were stories we lost. And with every girl that doesn't make it to school, we drown ourselves in may have beens and lost a potential too. How many more fatalities will it take for the glass ceiling to crumble and break, for the glass ceiling to disintegrate? You see, it took a well-read girl to get shot in head, to convince people to switch from bullets to pen, cause with ink we get peace in pieces. Cause when we read, we reason and wonder why it took violence and almost death to change the world poor on morals. It took a young girl with immense intellectual wealth. When will the greed to read reach more than the cream? When will the urge to learn be at arm's reach? When will we fill empty notebooks with stories we haven't read? Adapt, transform the very definitions of words. There's always an extra empty seat in some classroom and a girl somewhere with a want to learn, and we can't make these two meet. What have we really learned? What have we really learned we need to unlearn? Education shouldn't be something that one has to earn. We must fill hungry, curious minds with the right food for thought and be mindful of all that we have consciously forgot. I once heard that if you teach a woman, you teach a family, but I believe that if you teach a woman, you free a nation. It's time for the language of equality to no longer get lost in the translation. It's time for the language of equality to become mainstream communication. It's time for this language of equality to set base as the alphabets for the language of education. Thank you.
Let's continue with our last question for the day. A professional has to get a permit to take every breath and has to work as a fully automated and labor-saving robot all day long without any holidays, and still has others to control his or her rights. What profession is he or she in? No idea, right? Let's have a glimpse of what the profession really is and what he or she has to deal with.
तो कुछ ऐसा है कि देखो तुम मना नहीं करते। तो कुछ ऐसा है कि देखो तुम मना नहीं करते, इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि मान जाते हो। जब साड़ी के बदले सूट पहनने देते हो और ये बोलते हो कि हम तो बड़े दिल वाले हैं, घूंघट नहीं निकालोगे तो चलेगा, पर मांग पर लेना, हाथ में एक एक चूड़िया पहन लेना, उससे तुम्हारा क्या बिगड़ जाएगा? बड़ों की चार बात मान लोगी तो क्या पहाड़ टूट जाएगा? और फिर तुम अपना प्यार कुछ ऐसे जताते हो कि मुझे मेरे ही अधिकारों का दायरा समझाते हो। तुम मुझे बाहर जाने देते हो, मुझे नौकरी करने देते हो, डिनर टेबल पर बोलने का हक भी देते हो, मुझे मेरा नाम बहनाने देते हो, कभी कभी देर से भी उठने देते हो, और बस देते ही जाते हो। तो क्योंकि साथ जिंदगी भर का है और मैं भी एडजस्ट हो जाती हूँ और एडजस्ट होती ही चली जाती हूँ, तो बस वहीं पर बस हम सब खत्म हो जाते हैं। क्योंकि कौन पूछे तुमसे
कि आखिर देने वाले तुम होते कौन हो, क्योंकि कौन पूछे तुमसे कि आखिर देने वाले तुम होते कौन हो। मैं जो दे रहा हूँ बस वही तुम्हारा है। तो जो मैं हूँ, थी और हो सकती हूँ, उसके पन्ने तो फाड़ ही देने चाहिए, क्योंकि जब मैं पलट के देखूंगी तो मैं होंगी ही नहीं, मैं तो वो होंगी जो तुमने मुझे बनने दिया। मैं जिसको सूट नहीं स्कर्ट पसंद है, जो चूड़ी को जंजीर मानती है, जो रस्मों को नकारती है, जिसको आरती गाने की आदत नहीं है बट सम्मान करना जानती है, उसको तुम अपनी दुनिया के हिसाब का पाठ पढ़ाओगे, रोज दो कलम में दे सकने और नहीं दे सकने वाले अधिकार मुझे समझाओगे, और खुद बन जाओगे बड़े दिल वाले, और खुद बन जाओगे बड़े दिल वाले, क्योंकि तुमने मुझे वो दिया जो बड़े नसीब वालों को मिलता है। जैसे कि तुम हफ्ते में एक बार नाश्ता बना के इतराते हो, मेरे घर वालों को फोन करके मुझे जताते हो, और अगर किसी दिन कर लेते हो घर की सफाई तो मान ही लेते हो कि बेस्ट हस्बैंड की तोहफी तो तुम्हें ही मिलनी चाहिए। लेकिन तुम वो अवतार हो जो 16 सोमवार के बाद भी कोई नहीं पा सकता। लेकिन तुम तो वो अवतार हो जो 16 सोमवार के बाद भी कोई नहीं पा सकता। लेकिन मैंने भी कोई अच्छे कर्म किए होंगे, जो तुम मुझे मिल गए, और मैं भी इसी भ्रम से रह जाऊंगी कि मुझे इतना देने वाला मिल गया। मैं भूल जाऊंगी ये हक मैंने कभी किसी को दिया ही नहीं था, मेरी जंजीर की ताकत तय करने वाले तुम नहीं, मैं खुद थी, और मेरी चारों ओर कोई लकीर थी ही नहीं जो अब बनाने चले हो, मेरे पंख का साइज और अल्टीट्यूड तुम्हारे डायरे में नहीं आता, वैसा ही जैसा तुम्हारे मेरे अगर आता है तो एक दूसरे का साथ, अगर साथ कंडीशन अप्लाई के साथ आता है तो वो साथ नहीं वो हिसाब किताब है। और माफ करना, हिसाब किताब में मैं थोड़ी कच्ची हूँ, दिल से अभी भी बच्ची हूँ, मेरी उड़ान ही मेरी पहचान है, ये मैं स्कर्ट पहन के परू या साड़ी, इससे कैसे जुड़ जाएगा तुम्हारा सम्मान। मुझे किसी ऐसी डोर से ना बांधना जिसकी पकड़ तुम्हारे हाथ में हो, बल्कि ऐसी डोर से बांधना जिसमें हमारी उड़ान में एक दूसरे का साथ हो। और ये मैं एक तरफा बात नहीं कर रही, ये टू वे रास्ता है। मेरे रिस्पेक्ट के मायने को मेरे कपड़े रस्मों श्रृंगार से ना छोड़ना, और मेरे खाने बनाने की स्किल्स को मेरे संस्कारों से ना छोड़ना। ये मेरे शौक भी हो सकते हैं, इनको कंपलसरी सब्जेक्ट मत बनाना, बाकी मैं संभाल लूँगी तुम ज़्यादा मत घबराना,
On this, the answer is very clear. The profession is of a housewife who serves everyone in the family with different colors of life. Grohini, bada hi mamooli sa shabd hai, lekin iska arth bahut hi khas hai. Sara ghar jis karuni, wahi hai Grohini. So we should salute housewife and her profession.
If we set our mindset according to breaking bias, spreading light of equality, saluting women in all professions and respecting their rights, then this society can change into a better place.
Lovely performance by all the performers. Freedom and bravery. This is the reason why we sing our national anthem. We are free because we are brave. I would like to request everyone to stand up for the national anthem. Assembly Savdhan.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind Bharat Bhagya Vidhata पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल वंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्च जल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
Assembly Vishram. We are now moving towards the end of our assembly. I would like to invite Hemanya for the point to socho for today.
Women are the real architects of society. Women's Day is celebrated every year around the world to embed an idea of the importance of women. There is a need to celebrate Women's Day as women are often subjected to preconceived perceptions of what they can do and what they cannot. Today, women rule in almost every field of life and work at par with men. Women are influential everywhere, in industries, science, business, politics, education, sports, etc. The world has progressed and new visions and insights have been adapted. However, even still, women face the biased opinions of people. And statistics show that there is still a huge amount of people who treat different genders unequally. If women can top in almost any field of life and do the work with so much zeal and zest, then why should we stop them from coming forward and showcasing their talents? Zara socho.
We hope you enjoyed our assembly. Have a fantabulous Friday ahead. I would like to call the music team for the exit song.
Hey, bhai re. मारो गाडो भरेल भारे
हरे हर रे हर रे हंकारे मारो गाडो भरेल भारे मारो गाडो भरेल भारे
मैं तो लगाव दी थी हाथ हरिन मैं तो लगाव दी थी हाथ हरिन हर चाहे तो पार उतारे करने कुसुम कटाने पेट नु पाप पुकारे
Bye.
कई करणी करेल कई दे बदलू कटू कई पुण्य होय तो पंडने काजे दई दे ए सपना जेवी मुड़ी नदी रे ए सपना जेवी मुड़ी नदी दे आवे हारे हारे Oh, my name.